ياسين والقرآن الحكيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد, سورة ياسين is known as a Makki surah, which means it was revealed prior to the hijrah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now, when we open the Qur'an, we will notice that after many of the names of the surahs, it is clearly stated Makki or Madani. This does not mean that the surah was revealed in Mecca or revealed in Medina. However, what it means and what it stands for is this surah was revealed prior to the hijrah or after the hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some ayat are such that in some surahs, certain ayat were revealed in Mecca or in Medina. So therefore, this is not a conclusive statement to say that this is, if it says Makki, then all those ayat were revealed in Makkatul Mukarramah. Surah Yasin, the very common name of it, as we all know, is Surah Yasin, because this was mentioned by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we begin with the surah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today, inshallah, we will discuss three verses. And our objective of doing these verses at a time is to firstly memorize it, read it correctly, and also understand what the meaning of these ayat are. So we begin firstly with a recitation. The word Yasin, when we are reading, both of it has got a mud on it, so it will be lengthened slightly. Wal Qur'an il Hakim, the Qaf in Qur'an and the Ha in Hakim. So therefore, a very common mistake is it is read as Wal Qur'an il Hakim. We should ensure that we are reading as a Ha Wal Qur'an il Hakim. Thereafter, innaka laminal mursaleen, and the noon is mushaddad, therefore it will have a gunna, so we will pull it, so we will read it together. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Yasin wal Qur'anil Hakim. إنك لمن المرسلين. Inshallah, if we can commit these verses to memory, we now go on to the tafsir of this particular part of the surah. So taking into consideration the word Yasin. Yasin and is like many other letters in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts a surah with alphabets, with these words, with these alphabets. Sometimes you find alif lam mim, alif lam ra, ha mim, Taha, like that Yasin. These are known as Huruful Muqatta'at, which means these are those words which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone knows the meaning of. Now look at the beauty of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran in Arabic. So the Arabs all knew these letters. They all know what Ya is an alphabet, Sin is an alphabet. However, nobody knows the meaning of it. Allah is teaching us that despite how much we think we know, we still don't know. So this word Yasin in the Quran is known as Huruful Muqatta'at, those words which only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the meaning of. And most tafsirs will tell you, Allahu a'lamu bimuradihi bidhalik. Allah alone knows what this particular, what it means in particular. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala normally uses the Huruful Muqatta'at, and thereafter Allah introduces the Quran. So Alif Lam Mim, Dhalik Al-Kitab. Hamim wal Quran al Hakim. So many places Allah will take an oath on these letters. Thereafter, immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention the Quran. So Ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Yasin wal Quran al Hakim. And an oath in the Quran, Hakim means wise. The Quran is not only full of wisdom, but the Quran is also very decisive in whatever the Quran says. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Yasin, which we don't know the meaning of, وَالْقُرْآنِ الْحَكِيمِ. This Qur'an is a word full of advice, full of words of wisdom, and the Qur'an is very decisive in whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an. Thereafter, Allah gives us now, what is Allah taking an oath on? What is so important? إِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed, without doubt, you are amongst those who were sent. You are a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will continue with that tomorrow, insha'Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I accept all of your ibadah and du'as. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.